So, hi. Through this video, we are going to look at the day-to-day problems and how we can come up with systems to solve those problems. For example, I remember some years back, I had gone out of my home and there were plants which needed watering, but I did not have a solution to this, so I was just wondering if only I had a system which could take care of my plants when I am away from home. Sometimes when I go out of my home, there are elderly people who are not able to communicate with me. So I just thought, like, if again there was a system which could communicate on their behalf and tell me about the well-being of the people. I'm sure such incidences or such things happen to many people around us day to day, and we feel that there should be some systems or some help from electronics systems that we can use in order to solve these problems. Then as a teacher, I interact with so many students every day. And then they have some wonderful ideas which they wish to implement, but again they are not having that much of knowledge to implement those, or maybe they are not aware of what are the things that are available by which they can implement their ideas. At the same time, I also interact with students who are in their final years, or they have some great ideas through which they want to have their own startup. So basically, some idea which you want to implement, but you are not aware of how to implement that. In technical terms, we call this as a prototype. So we want to build a prototype, but we want to do it fast. We want to do it at a very low cost so that we are not spending too much on it. And at the same time, that idea is getting converted into the solution which we require for us. Now, when you are building any system, any such system which is going to solve a particular problem, electronic system, at the heart of any system, not only electronic, if you look at our bodies, the system that is controlling the entire functioning of our body is the brain, right? So when we say that the brain is controlling our actions, and we are doing certain actions according to what we require, that system we call it as an intelligent system. So similarly, in electronic systems as well, there is an intelligent part or a device which will be controlling all the other components and other devices in that particular system. Now, who does this function of the intelligent system? So that is, in electronic terms, it is a microprocessor or a microcontroller. Now, there are so many varieties of these intelligent systems available. For example, if you just Google microprocessor, the word microprocessor, you will get 3 crore hits within some seconds. At the same time, if you Google microcontroller, you will get 10 crores of hits within seconds. So how do you decide which microcontroller or which microprocessor should I use for prototyping or for building or implementing the idea that I want to implement? So don't worry, there is a better and a simpler solution for your problem. And that is using the system or the board which is known as the Arduino board. Now this Arduino board has become very, very popular, and so many people not all over the world are using these boards. Now why do we use these Arduino boards? The first and the most important reason is that it is an open source hardware. I mean, when you are buying the Arduino board, you don't have to pay any license fee for that. So you can come up with your system at a very low cost. At the same time, it is very, very easy to write the coding for that particular board. if you consider, say, other microcontrollers, naturally you have to learn, you have to go through the entire process of learning the programming part of that, and it's not very easy. But this Arduino boards, it is very easy to program the board. So software part is taken care of. At the same time, when you consider the hardware of the Arduino board, the people at the Arduino, they have developed this board so that it can be used even by a hobbyist, even by a person who is, or even by school children, by a person who has no knowledge, no ABC of electronic systems. So it is as easy as that. At the same time, they are available in many versions, from low end to the high end. So all your requirements are taken care of, and they are easily available all throughout in the market. So if I want to buy a Arduino board, just, you know, I can get it online, or I can go to a hardware shop and it is available there. So these are the advantages. Again, when you are writing the code for the Arduino board, naturally we are going to use either a desktop or a laptop for writing the code, and we use what is called as a development environment. Now this development environment of the Arduino, for that you don't need a particular operating system in your desktop or laptop. For example, for some environments you need to have a Windows in your laptop. For some, you need to have some other systems. But here, for the Arduino, you may use, it is, we call it as a cross platform. That is, you can have any operating system and you can write the code for the Arduino. So it has the advantage of being easy on the software part, as well as easy on easy and fast on the hardware implementation as well. So these are the some of the advantages that Arduino board have. And so what we recommend, or what I would suggest, that if you are a hobbyist, if you are a school goer, you want to have built some system, you have some fantastic idea and you want to implement that idea in a very, you know, less time and inexpensive way. At the same time, if you are a student who want to implement, maybe an engineering student as well, if you want to implement your idea faster, cheaper, and you don't want to spend too much time writing the code, and you are, maybe some people, you know, they, when it comes to electronic systems, or even when we say that these are also called as embedded systems, students are, you know, wary of that. They feel that, no, I am not able to do that. They don't have confidence of, because they say that I am not good at coding. But for Arduino, the coding is so simple that you don't have to be an expert coder in order to write the code for that. So you can build your system with the Arduino board in a very fast way, simple way, and spending to not much from your pocket. So that is the reason why I would suggest use the Arduino board. And another advantage is that the software as well as the hardware. Now, for example, if you are saying that you want to have your own prototype, you want to have your own startup, then it's if you use the Arduino board, it is open source. You can use the hardware and you can make changes in the hardware as well as the software part and implement your system. So it's something like, you know, a solution not only at a lower level. It's for, I would say, it's a solution that can be used for at all the levels. But at the same time, yes, I would also say that if you are a for a startup at this proof of concept level, using the Arduino board is fine. If you are an engineering student, using this for a, you know, just implementing your idea is fine. But if you want to multiply, like for example, if you come up, this idea works, okay, you show the proof of concept through the Arduino, and then you want to build, you want to multiply your product, you want to, you know, market your product, or you want to come up with your own solution, then I would recommend that for prototyping, you use the Arduino, and then using your knowledge, you can build your own system using the microcontrollers or the microprocessors available. Design your own system. There are other methods which you can use. For example, you can simulate it using the online simulations, and then you can go for the actual designing and implementing it with the actual hardware. So this is what I had to say about the Arduino board. So happy Arduino boarding. Thanks.